Oh, Lord. Brought to you from somewhere out there in the cockles of imagination and the internet. Welcome to the Gaming Galleon. I am Cap'n Riz, nobody special, just a guy who happened to, somehow in life, end up with a pirate ship. I mean, this happens. How many people have you heard of who, got a Ferrari when they were 16? I never got that. How about these guys who had a 3DO back in the 90s? Seriously? How'd you end up with that? Well, I never had any of those things. But somehow, the fates ended me up with this pirate ship. And what better way to use a pirate ship, for God's sakes, than to travel the world? And that's what we do each week. And I can't do it without each and every one of you out there pulling on the lines, bringing the gangplanks back out of the water, and dropping the anchor to our destination week after week after week. And this week, a very exciting stop. We're in Kiev, Ukraine. Kiev, Ukraine. Have you heard of it? You may have heard of the Ukraine. And, you know, I was thinking about it this morning. How many countries can you think of? Because when I think of the Ukraine, I think of the Ukraine. How many countries can you think of that start with the? It's not the Mexico. It's not the Chile. It's not the France. It's the Ukraine. And the only other one I can think of is the United States. Can you think of any others? Let me know. We got a lot to do. We're going to be here in Ukraine playing the Red Star. One of these games on the PS2. One of the many games on the PS2. That you should know about, and for some reason maybe have not. Great game. I mean, look at the chick here. You got your main character here. She's double fisting. She's got an Uzi in one hand, and my God, a sickle in the other. Sick. Oh, we'll also be digging into the booty. Lots of good stuff out here. Thank God we're out outside of heavily legalized waters, because some of the stuff in here, we'd probably raise a couple eyebrows over. And, of course, we're going to take the time for you folks out there, the bag that tells no tales. However, I'm actually overriding this week, if I may, because this whole show got inspired by someone who happened to come on board one day and stop in the mess hall. Now, if you don't know, the other 24 hours, how many hours are in a week? 24 times 7 minus 1. What is that? I don't know. Somewhere around 175 hours? Who knows? Anyway, every other hour that we're not live, we're only live 1 hour a week or so. All the other times, running our old shows on Twitch. If you don't know what Twitch is, maybe you're watching this on YouTube, or maybe you're watching this 100 years in the future and just happen to catch the sound waves going through space, but that's not how the internet works, isn't it? Anyway, Twitch is basically where we run our show 24 hours a day for anyone who cares to watch. And one morning, which is usually, you know, I'm not always in there, but I'm in there now and then. One morning, a gentleman came in, and we got to discussing the show and the pirate ship, and he revealed to me that he lives in the Ukraine. Kiev, Ukraine! And I just found that fascinating, that someone in a country that I know little to nothing about, I'm not even sure I could point it out on a map where the Ukraine is. And here, this person is taking the time to watch, you know, our doings here on the Gaming Galleon. I found that absolutely fascinating. So I asked him, you know, what kind of video games he likes to play, what kind of game he would pick if we were to go to Russia. He suggested, and I picked the Red Star. You know, I said I always wanted to do a show in that area. The Red Star, I always wanted to do a show on the Red Star, but I was never, I don't know anything about Russia. So it's neat to meet you. You can tell me a little bit about that area. And the Ukraine is not exactly part of Russia. In fact, it's not at all. Let's take a look. Find out exactly where the Ukraine is. So if this is Europe, there's Europe. You got Spain down here. That's where Assassin's Creed took place. Is that right? No, that's not right at all. It was Jerusalem, wasn't it? I'm an idiot. Was it Assassin's Creed 2? Who knows? Anyway, this circle, that's the Ukraine. It's set up right at all this other land here. That's all Russia. Okay, so basically the Ukraine is the last port in the storm before you end up into the gigantic tundra that is Russia. And that little dot there, that little peg that you see there, that's the capital of Ukraine, otherwise known as Kiev. So that's where our friend Alexander sits, probably asleep right now because he's on the other side of the world. Or maybe he's behind his computer playing one of those great games out there. But when I asked him what game he picked, he would say, no, I don't know what this Red Star crap is. Pick Metro. It's a game about traveling through subways because the surface of the world has been radiated. And the whole game of Metro takes place in Moscow or underneath Moscow. Well, that's all well and good, but Alexander, you're not in Kiev, or you're not in Moscow. You're in Kiev, Ukraine, so maybe we'll save the Metro for another day. Sounds like a fun game. I'll have to look it up. But again, my main goal here was to get the Red Star and to play it on a good game, because it's just one of those games on the PS2 that no one knows about, no one cares about. And once you've played it, you really scratch your head asking yourself why. It's really funny, though. This was actually based off of a comic book originally. I didn't read much about the comic book. I wasn't that interested. But basically, the Red Star takes place in a parallel dimension from our own. If you're not familiar with the term parallel dimension, basically, when you grab an apple, you have two options. You can either bite the apple or set the apple down. Depending on what you do, will skew two totally separate dimensions. So somewhere out there, there is, you know, a dimension where Raz eats the apple and a second dimension where he sets the apple down. We're probably living in the one where I set it down, taking a look at me. But anyway, Red Star takes place in a separate parallel dimension. Another Soviet era, and basically it's Soviets fighting Soviets. It's the most convoluted storyline I've come across. A lot of video games, there's always, you know, there's the obligatory, like, text-based pictures talking to one another for a good 2 minutes before each level. You forward right past that. Even the instruction manual, this is the first time I've ever seen this. The instruction manual even glazes over the story. There is no story portion in the instruction manual. It's all controls. And I think that that's great, because that means that here's a developer, XS Games, company I know, Archangel Studios, you know, a company, a developer and a publisher I'd never heard of, were really putting the gameplay first here. So I think it's time to get started. It's the Red Star for the PlayStation 2. If you see it, pick it up. I assure you, you won't be disappointed. Let's bring out the old harp of transition. Let's send this one out to Alexander, all the way out in Kiev, Ukraine. Well, for you, we're right here in town. It's been nice. We'll talk about it later. Good food here. Good food. It's the Red Star for the PlayStation 2.
Alright.
Okay. So, yeah, again, this chick...
Oh, boy.
Into my headphones here. Oh, yeah, listen to that beat. Awesome. So, yeah, double fisting. Guns don't work, you gotta get in there with the hammer and sickle. And that's why this is such a great game, because it's basically part shooter, part beat 'em up. You see? Look at it. How many games you played with a sickle, huh? It's bombed out, it's snowy. Uh-oh. Oh, we're getting backstabbed. Oh man, I love that stereo sound. Ah! Alright, now that was just... Oh, look at it! You can see the ship in the reflection of the ice. That's awesome. What a cool detail. So yeah, again, you know, you'll forgive me if I'm not regaling you with the deep politics of this game. Glancing at the cutscenes beforehand. It's not like the CGI or anything. Literally, like, two pictures and a bunch of text. Uh-oh. It's very confusing. Lots of long Russian names. Describing different factions. I don't know who this woman is. I guess we can look that up in the instructions. You'll notice that there's space here in the upper right-hand corner for... Oh, I overheated my gun. Hold on. Blue steel. It's called Blue Steel. Now, I wonder how far this movie was from Zoolander. Is Zoolander in there? Anybody see the sequel? I hear it sucks. Huh. Oh, yeah. Line them up. Knock them down. Is this not awesome? So, yeah, you can... there is room for another life bar there in the upper right-hand corner. You can bring in a friend. And the game starts you out with two people to choose from. There's your classic speedy character, that's this chick. And then more of a brute kind of guy. From what I understand, the comic book really deals a lot with the time in history when World War II had a lot of rumors of... factions researching black magic and sorcery. So this is actually a game that kind of rolls with that mythos. So these guys here with these big sticks, you'll notice they're not even touching these sticks when they attack with them. You see that? I think it hit the second stick. They're actually mind controlling those staffs. Those blades. And the brute character that you can play, he is one of those guys. So he's actually rocking one of those mind sticks, if you will. Looks like I've got my superpower here. Let's use it. Not that exciting. But there are a number of combos. Uh-oh. There's a dash attack. There's a block here. You can even block. That may come in later if you run into somebody really nasty. I warmed up a little bit with this game. I played the first level enough to get through the obligatory, you know, totally boring tutorials. that, you know, you're kind of forced into when you get later into video gaming is video gaming. There's a little bit of that here, but once you get into the second level, you're basically on your own, left your own devices. So I'm essentially playing this level from here on out blind. I've never played this. It's not to say I'm awesome or anything. This is only the second level. Oh boy, here we go. Alright, let's try and take this fool out. And we'll see where we are in time. And, this guy takes us a while, I think we've got about 5 minutes to play with here before the booty segment. Oh, I'm overheating. Oh, you see this? It's kind of changed from beat-em-up to a little bit of a bullet hell here. Pretty cool. He was a snap. Oh, he's big. Okay. See, how do I deal with the big ones? I'm forgetting something. Oh. Kiev, Ukraine, let me tell you about this place. Now, honestly, it's a lot like Indianapolis, to be honest. It's just got a lot more capital buildings that look like really old castles. And, you know, the first thing that came to my mind when I thought Kiev, Ukraine, you know, call me a stupid American, I thought of Chicken Kiev. And I was like, is this, like, where they invented that? And so we're at dinner, and, you know, the guy's like, no, that's Chicken Supreme here. And he even had, like, an even more Russian name that obviously I can't pronounce. I'm an idiot. But apparently, Chicken Kiev is not Russian. Not that anyone really, I mean, do you know what Kiev means? Have you ever even thought about it? Do you even know what Chicken Kiev is? Is that just me? This is something that my mom used to make for me as a kid. They were delicious. It's basically something you get in a supermarket for like $2. It's like a breaded, I know this is gonna sound gross, and it's not, but it's really not in practice, but the way I put it, it's basically a chicken egg. Like, and what I mean by that is not an egg. Uh-oh, there's another ship coming in, you see that? We got bombs coming in. It's not an egg, it's like if an egg was made from chicken meat. Okay? That's what I'm saying. Think an egg, but instead of a shell, it's made from chicken meat. And it's breaded. Oh. Maybe even deep fried, but certainly breaded. And it's frozen. What's inside the egg? Well, it's like a smattering of herb and butter. So think about that. You put that in the oven for, you know, 10 minutes or something. You got yourself one heck of a treat. It's very much like a chicken cordon bleu. The only difference is we're talking, you know, butter and herb here. Does anyone even care what I'm talking about? Kill the Russians! Kill the parallel dimension Russians! So anyway, I looked up what Kiev, how it came to be, because it's not Russian. Apparently, chicken Kiev's a French dish. It's made by some French guy way back in the day, probably 19th century. And the term Kiev is supposedly came from New York restaurants when all the immigrants came in. Oh, to appeal to Russian immigrants. Call Chicken Kiev, maybe we'll get some of that Russian coin coming in from overseas. And apparently, once World War II hit, the name migrated from America all the way over to Europe, and eventually even to Russia. What does this have to do with Kiev, Ukraine? That's the moral. Nothing. But I do find that kind of fascinating. And delicious. Oh, I overheated. Too busy thinking of drinking Kiev. We're running out of time here. Once we take down this tank, it's booty time. You hear that, Magnum? I don't find you intimidating. I've got a lot to offer a girl. Boom. Woo! That'll do, my friends. That'll do. Let's get a little harp action here. Come back for the booty segment. Hey, look at that. I got my... Got an A. Only I could have pulled that up in high school, huh? All right, it's booty time. Great game, Red. The Red Star, two-player. You'll notice there's a blonde chick back there. You know, we're playing her. That other guy you can play right out of the box. It's two-player, one-player, whatever. And then you got a chick back there. She's supposedly like a full-on sorcerer. She's not unlocked, but she's supposed to be like full-on long-range. You know, just short of doing fireballs and lightning bolts. So, sounds pretty cool to me. And I love that you get to spend money in between each round and customize your guy the way you want to play. It's pretty hot. Two-player. Never played a two-player. I bet it's a blast, though. Okay, good. I'm just getting us to where we need to be here. That should be fine. No one attack me, please. No one attack me, please. No one attack me, please. Okay, and we're good. Okay, booty. Lots to get through. Let's get started. This is a handheld smorgasbord, okay? A handheld smorgasbord. We've had this one sitting in the wings for quite a while. It just kept getting bumped. But it's a nice little package. I'm very excited to finally show it off to you guys. Because that means once you guys get to see it, we can finally file it away in the hold. Along with all its sisters and brothers, and really amass our ultimate collection. And in this case, we're adding to our Game Gear collection. We found this at a pawn shop. This is actually one that Biz came across and got a hold of me about. It originally was going for $60. Not so much. Okay? You don't need this stuff. It's not a kidney. Okay? Sit on it. Wait. Be patient. Or hell, even let it go. Sometimes you just gotta let it go. For $60, we're looking at a Game Gear. We're looking at about 10 games here. That's a let it go. Okay? But we were patient. We let it sit in this cabinet under glass for a while with that big fat price tag on it. We let a couple people buy it and send it back. We let it find itself back into the back room where it was forgotten until one day old Cap'n Raz, the pirate who never forgets, comes back months later and says, "All right, Biz, let's see that Game Gear." So he pulls it out. He says it's been brought back a couple times, complaining that the machine does not work. And he's looking up a price. It says to his manager, "What can we do with the Game Gear? It came back broken." She shrugs. She says, $20. $20. Okay? So that's what we did for this. Let's take a look at what we got. For $20, it came with this handy, fancy carrying case that says Game System. This isn't officially licensed. Just saying Game System. All right? Inside, we've got our Game Gear. Got our Game Gear here. It looks like it's in nice condition. Hold on a second. Looks like it's in pretty decent condition. There's no real scratches to it. It's really dark. But it's good. It's okay. Looks like it's in pretty good shape. It's got the battery covers. Don't see that every day. Yeah, in general, it's in good condition, but when you switch her on, and I don't think we have batteries in here. Basically, we're getting video with this. We're getting audio with this, but not video. It was coming up kind of black with some lines. The audio sounds great, which is ironic because generally, game gears will have bad audio. The capacitors for the audio will just run out, and you'll barely be able to hear it. But this one sounds fine. It just, for whatever reason, we've got no video with this. So basically, we're buying this for the games. Okay, let's take a look and see what kind of games we have here. We do have a working system in the hold, so that's not an issue. Sorry, I'm checking my time. Okay. So let's go through the games. One I don't see often, and for good reason. It's really not that great of a game. One of the many Sonic games that were on the Game Gear. Sonic Labyrinth. The autofocus. And the autofocus. Okay. Sonic Labyrinth. Ah! You get a look there? It's good enough, right? It's not going to zoom in for me. It's not going to focus for me. Screw it. So Sonic Labyrinth is basically not a Sonic game, at least not what you're thinking of. It's more isometric, kind of like Zaxxon. Not that great. I'm not even sure why they made it for the Game Gear. Okay. What do we have next? Aside from that one, a couple accessories here. You've got the Game Gear battery, which goes on the back there. It goes on the back like so. It screws in with this thing. If you find any of these days and it works, I'll be shocked. Now, I haven't really put this one through the paces, mainly because it's kind of been sitting on standby, waiting for you, you know, to be shown to you guys. But we have one of these in the hold. We have the official Game Gear battery in the hold, and these things just don't hold charges anymore. It's just too old. So if you're looking for a handheld and you come across this and you think, and this is like the determining factor, you think you're getting a deal, chances are this thing isn't working. So just keep that in mind. Okay? Make sure that the Game Gears are going to run off batteries. Or run off one of these. This was a nice ad. You've got the Game Gear AC adapter. I remember having a Game Gear, and I don't know where I got it from, but man, I was like, I must have got it from a thrift store or something. This is way when I was a kid, and I remember playing, like, Shining Force on the Game Gear all the way through as a kid with one of these, or a teenager, plugged into the wall, and it just makes me wonder, where the hell did I get a Game Gear? Because I know my parents didn't get me one. They got me a Nintendo and a Game Boy. The rest was on my own. I remember trading my Nintendo in for the Super Nintendo. I have no idea where I could have gotten a Game Gear with, like, Shining Force and, like, Axe Battler. I remember playing Axe Battler on that thing, too. That's weird. Anyway, AC adapter means if we have a Game Gear, we can play this all day, and I don't think we had one of these with our original Game Gear, so this is a nice add to our modest Game Gear collection. As for the games themselves, we've got 5, 8. So we're looking at 9 games here, all in the cases. Let's see what we have here. Extremely common for the Game Gear is Mortal Kombat. You're always going to find somebody who's like, you know, Mortal Kombat's not that bad on the Game Gear. I don't know how good it is. I mean, first of all, you only got two buttons. You're going to find this in pretty much every Game Gear lot ever. Sonic 2 featuring Tails. I hear this is one of the lower end Sonic games on the system. And it was packed in with the Game Gear, so it's pretty much everywhere. This is a nice find. Pretty decent runner and run and gunner. Jurassic Park: The Lost World. Not too bad at all. You got a run button, you got a jump button, or a jump button and a shoot button. And there's dinosaurs. How can you go wrong? Also, this one I don't remember much about. This may be the one where you could play a dinosaur. I think you play a Grant and a dinosaur. So the other Jurassic Park, someone was a fan. I hope you guys can hear me. Yeah. Biz is so much taller than I am. Yeah. Need to push this back. But anyway, this is interesting. Keeping with the somebody loved dinosaurs. Somebody loved dinosaurs. You got Primal Rage. Primal Rage, which is the Street Fighter of the Mesozoic era. That's not right. Somebody can correct me. And my glasses are falling apart. Look, I have the money to get my glasses. I just don't have the motivation to sit in there and get it taken care of. It's so stupid. The glasses store is right next to the retro video game store. And I have no problem walking in there and spending an hour. I'm going to get my glasses fixed. Anyway, Primal Rage. They got this at Boss Battle Arcade, so we can play this in the arcade all the time. But it's like, you know, you ever wanted to see a T-Rex fight a raptor? Here you go. I don't know. Never been the biggest fan of it, but it is pretty cool to see this on the Game Gear. I wonder what that's like. I just imagine it being like so not good on the Game Gear. Alien 3, another good run and gunner. Another good run and gunner on a lot of different platforms. Sega Genesis is really good. I hear it's not so good on the Nintendo. We do not have it for the Nintendo. The Nintendo Entertainment System. So it's pretty cool to find this for the Game Gear. Probably my I think I was probably the most excited about this one. Of the ones we found. And it's nice. We found no sports games here. I might be jinxing myself. We got Super Battle Tank. Super Battle Tank. Who doesn't want to turn their Game Gear into a battle tank? It's pretty hot. And then finally, probably the least desirable in the lot. For me personally, maybe not for you. Garfield Caught in the Act. I'm not a big fan of Garfield. You know, it must be nice to just sit around and, you know, dream of lasagna all day. I wish I could do that. I love lasagna. Anyway, that's 9 games. Plus the plug, the Game Gear, the battery pack. What are we looking at? That $20 for that? So you're looking around $2 for a game. $2 a game, and maybe $2 for the plug. And then the Game Gear is a real question mark. Can we get it fixed? I don't know. I know my buddy in Boss Battles likes to tinker with this stuff. And he's a Game Gear fan, so I'm probably going to throw it his way. Who knows? Maybe we can get it fixed. But for now, we've got a very good working Game Gear game. We've got a very respectable Game Gear collection. And if you didn't know, a little company called Hyperkin, aka the creators of the Retron 5, have just released an adapter that you can plug into your Retron 5 to play Sega Master System games and Sega Game Gear games. This is really the first time in history that people have had the ability to play Game Gear on the big screen using the authentic software. So I'm very excited about that addition, and you know, that really legitimizes this bundle a lot more as a result. Okay. We're at 35. That's pretty good. I think we're right on time. So I'll keep these over here for now. Two very interesting developments today. Let's get started with the first one. We went to a liquidator today. And this is one of the weirdest places. They get these boxes. They've started this ever since the new year. They have gotten these boxes from Amazon Prime. We're, you know, in Indianapolis, there is, I guess, an Amazon Prime warehouse in the city. So as a result, there's a lot of stuff coming through here and a lot of overflow. So Amazon will sell these giant boxes, like the size of a coffin, full of technology that either got returned or whatnot. And they'll sell them to liquidators. And then this, at least this liquidator that I know of, will put that box in the middle of the storeroom, and anything in there, they'll open it up, have no idea what's in there, and they'll open it up, and anything that's in there is $5 a piece. Okay? Is that good? Well, you be the judge. I walked in there, and it was like a cadaver being diced up by a bunch of zombies. There were like five people digging their hands into this box, these two boxes. And I'm like, well, clearly there's not going to be anything in there. I'm just doing a kind of once over the store. I brush by there. And what do I see sitting in this box that no one else seems to care about? Again, I'm telling you, I don't know how long that box is sitting there, but there are five people going at it, grabbing stuff, and no one seemed to care about this. The FC Pocket. Yeah, we were at the FC Pocket. Sorry, I lost broadcast there for a second. So no cheating it. It just happened. Anyway, the FC Pocket. This is sitting in a box all by itself. What is it? Well, let's take a closer look at it, shall we? Is it brand new? Who can say? But it looks a lot like a Famicom, otherwise known as the Japanese Nintendo Entertainment System. Okay? Looking in the bag here, you got a little comfort bag, a little tote bag, if you will. You've got charger plug. You've got AC plug that plugs into the machine, and supposedly that would allow you to play whatever games you're playing here on a big screen. I've encountered these and usually not working. And then finally, there's a little itty bitty cartridge with some Chinese characters on there that fits in the top. Like so. Very ghetto. Very ghetto. But if you turn this thing on after charging it, gives a little English option. That's if you want English or Japanese, English or Chinese. And then that says 478 and 1. And it's a whole bunch of Nintendo games. Some stuff here that I love. Right on the front, there's Mighty Final Fight, a game that costs like over $200. There's Contra, Jackal, Ninja Gaiden 2. This is just on the first page. And then even Super Mario Brothers 3. Right there. Good to go. Let's get some audio on it. Ooh, it sounds fast. Sound fast to you? This is fascinating. Watch me play the first level of Super Mario 3. Well, it seems to be playing right. Yeah, it seems like there's some audio emulation issues here. But it's got, like, some really rare games, including a game probably my most wanted game on the NES. DuckTales 2 is on this. Chippendale's Rescue Rangers 2 is on this. Gunknack, which is probably the best shooter on the system. A whole bunch of other shooters here, Life Force, Gradius, Star Soldier, yada yada. It's got 4 buttons there. The buttons being for B, A, and then turbo. These two up here are rapid fire, which is great because that was really what was missing from a lot of shooters for the NES was the ability to auto fire. They really needed that. The NES Advantage really helped out a lot of some of the 8-bit shooters out for the system. Little Samson, probably the most desired game on the library, is probably on this. But the funny thing about, I've come across these now and then, and it always seems like Little Samson itself, for whatever reason, they don't write it in English. And I'm not going to sit here and dig through it, but I can only assume it's on here somewhere. Be kind of surprising if it's not. But man, there's some good stuff here. Some real good stuff. Stuff we have in the hole, but still awesome to have in the palm of your hand. This was in the $5 box. Also in the $5 box was the third-party PS3 controller. These things are always sketchy. But I've actually pulled a few of these out of these $5 boxes in the past. And so I have tested them, everything I need to charge it and make it compatible with the PS3. So I grabbed the PS3 controller, a charge cable that I found in there, this, and then I go up to the desk, put the PS3 controller on top of this thing, slid it over. And they're like, that'll be $5 for both. So we got this guy for $250. How about that, huh? All right, finally. You want to see the coolest Game Boy Advance in your life? All right, we've talked about how there are two kinds of Game Boy Advance SPs in the past. The Game Boy Advance SP you're looking for, if you're trying to buy one, is an AES 101. The AES 001 you do not want to buy, because the screen is much, much less desirable. Not nearly as effective as the 101. So we have a 1101. We used to have 2. I was stupid enough to let my little baby nephew fool around with my other one, and he dropped it and broke it. So we have 1 of these awesome ones. We have a whole bunch of other Game Boy SPs, but this is the only 101 we have, okay? I walked into a thrift store today. First of all, I walked into a retro video game store and we came across 2 of these for $2 each. These are wireless connectors for the Game Boy. Okay? Why are these great? Well, there are a lot of great two-player games on the Game Boy aside from just Pokemon. The best one being Konami Arcade Classics. Very cheap game for $2, but you got 2 of those. You can play like 2-player Russian Attack. You can play 2-player Frogger. You can play Yar Kung Fu, and each player can pick all the characters in Yar Kung Fu. I'm not going to waste your time trying to explain what that means, but if you know Yar Kung Fu, you may be dropping your draw right now. So that goes right there. Now we can play each other anywhere in the room. Don't have to be hunched together. I think that's pretty cool. $2 each. We grabbed 2 of those. So now we can connect 2 of our Game Boy Advances. Then I went to a thrift store down the street, and I found this thing. Look at that. Now, basically what this is a memory, is a battery pack. You've seen these all over the place. But this one's special. This one triples your battery power. And you'll notice that we kind of had to screw it on the back. So this actually came with a screwdriver for the Game Boy Advance SP. And if I had to, and let me just tell you that working on Nintendo hardware is a nightmare, because every screw they come up with, every little piece that they make, is solely for Nintendo products. So you can't just take a flip screwdriver and open up like a Game Boy. Or, a Nintendo. It's like every little screw is especially for the Game Boy and the GameCube and stuff like that, all individual. Even like the plugs, you know, it's like everything is made in-house. So the fact that this thing had a screwdriver alone was almost worth the price of admission. Now this battery pack, you'll notice there's a little switch here. There's a little switch right there, black switch. And it says A and B. So you pop this thing in, you pull out the original Game Boy Advance SP battery, you pop this thing in, and you're like, you know, I hope this is as good as a Nintendo battery. Then you notice that there's a little door here that opens up. I'm not going to open it up. It's not really worth the time. But that's a carriage for your original battery. So you're not losing a Nintendo product by adding this thing. You're gaining a second battery, and that AB switch is all you need to do to switch between the two. Isn't that amazing? So this is like, you know, this is like a 30-hour battery here. 50 if you don't use the backlighting. So pretty awesome. So we've got our wireless receiver. We've got our 3x battery. And then finally the coup de grace in the same thrift store. We happened upon these headphones. Neck bag headphones for the Game Boy Advance SP. Well, what's the big deal? And at $4, I mean, that's highway robbery. This battery pack thing was $5. It sounds expensive, but again, think about that screwdriver. That screwdriver alone is probably going to cost you somewhere around $5 just to get it to your house. And once I saw that the second battery is still there, I was sold. $4 on this. Why is this a good deal? It's really not. But, again, talking about Game Boys, the Game Boy SP has no headphone jack. So, the headphones for a Game Boy SP, that's your plug. So, these are some officially licensed Nintendo headphones that you need to be able to get stereo sound from your Game Boy. So, you got to take off your wireless adapter, plug it in there, you're good to go, okay? All right, so there you go. It's the ultimate Game Boy Advance SP. You really can't get much ritzier than what we've got going on here. Is it beat up? Is it scratched to heck? Yeah, but that just gives it character. All right, let's get back to the Red Star. We're probably way behind in time. I'm going to say we got about 10 minutes left in the show, maybe? All right, let's get started. We'll just tool around a little more with the Red Star, and then we'll say goodbye. All right, here we go. It's the Red Star for the PS2. All right. What's going on? Nothing? Okay. Dogs are going crazy. See those dogs over there? That's the kennel. Some idiot, when they designed the ship, decided, let's put the kennel right next to the captain's quarters. Why? Well, it's security purposes. Who's gonna screw with the captain? But there's a bunch of dogs around. Yeah, well, you know what? The dogs are locked up, you idiot. How's that gonna help? Huh. Huh. Select for enemy data. That's mine.
Ooh. Oh. Nice. Nice music.
Got a guy dropping mortars here. A lot of variety in the enemies. And there is variety from level to level. Don't forget you can block, Riz. I overheated. Cannon spike. Now that I'm thinking about it. That was a great top-down shooter for the Dreamcast. The Red Star won't cost you much, somewhere between... I mean, I hope it's not going up in price. I think I got it for $7, maybe about 2 years ago. There it is. Boom. Sorry if I'm not being too chatty right now. I'm getting in the mix. What did I do there? Combo. See that? That was almost like a finishing move. I'm gonna air combo this guy. I really want to play this two player. Looks like a shielding. Ah. See that combo? I'm trying to get the combo up. Ah! And that, see, I'm hot dogging, and that's what I'm getting. Oh, we're going out of time. Better wrap this up. Ah! I smell a big fight. The guys in the mortars. Ah! Have I shown my metal yet? Alright, here we go. Let's take this guy out and then we'll wrap her up. Trina time 16. Pull down that gun. I'm gonna try and peel away mosses like this, like an onion. That way, all their fire is coming from one way. Overheat. Ugh. Oh, I tried to alien. Whew, that was pretty awesome. All right, we're done. That's it! Abort! Quick! Aren't you excited? I'm excited. Biz is over here. He's walked in. We've got a shoot coming up here at the end of the show. We're going to be doing a song. And he looks like he couldn't be more bored. Okay, great. That's lovely. We got a B rank on that. Not too bad. Let's check out the mail here. So this, I'm going to override your moment in the sun, if you don't mind, for Alexander. He sent us I asked him, you know, I want to tie this whole episode up, so if you could just send us something from the mail, that'd be really nice. So here it is. This is from Alexander, all the way from Kiev, Ukraine. And he writes, "Dear Cap and Raz, who was a Russian leader that killed thousands? Answer? Stalin, goddammit, Stalin!" From Alexander. Well, apparently, maybe they do mail a little differently. You're supposed to have the cap and answer, but, you know, that's fine. That's okay. Hey, you know, different. This is why we travel around the world, to learn different cultures. All right, that's it. Thanks for playing. Thanks for coming to the Ukraine with me. Pick up the Red Star. Awesome game. And for God's sakes, keep using your imagination out there, okay? It's the only one you got, and don't ever let anybody take it from you. Okay. Thanks again. We'll see you next time. Not sure when, not sure where, but I know one thing. Wherever we're going, we'll go together. So until then, farewell and adieu. So you want to come sing? Come on, get up here. Come on, here we go. That's the spirit. Well, I want to do the Spanish maidens. God, you're tall. Well, I want to ye ladies of Spain, for we received orders for to head to the Ukraine, and we may never see ye fair ladies again. Chicken Kiev or Cordon Bleu? What do you think? For God's sake.
How do you get it into that shape?
I don't know. That's a good question. Keep your powder dry, mateys.